and inevitable as they reflect objective trends and the new needs of social development.
You know, against the backdrop of the Cold War, the leaders of two countries made a very correct decision. They normalized the relations between China and the United States. Time has changed. The two countries have changed. So, but when I think when you try to develop a relationship which could be conducive to both countries, in my idea, I put more emphasis on what has not changed. The thing that has not changed is, number one, the common interest between the two countries. So I think the nearly 50 years of interactions between China and the United States have brought tremendous benefits to the peoples of our countries and the world. They who still bear that in mind and try not to seek unilateral advantage or widening the lead by a certain country and push down the other side. And second, I think the responsibility of China is growing in its influence in the international affairs. And the United States continue to be the only superpower in the world. So I think together with countries in the world, we, the China and the United States, together with others, share the common responsibility to bring about a better world